piano department event. When I was thinking of someone to invite to work with the students and to do a concert, a demonstration concert, I couldn't think of anyone more fitting for this event than Dr. Michael Barron, who was actually my first teacher here in the United States. I came on a scholarship when I was 15 years old, and Dr. Barron really shaped me as a pianist and musician in many ways. So I am happy to now play a program of four-hand music for you. This is two pianists and one piano. It seems like it would be easier because we're playing on half the piano, but it actually makes it a lot harder because you have to make decisions together about the type of sound that you want and the musical direction of the piece. So I also have six pairs of students playing duets. So this is a good, just me actually doing what I'm telling them to do, hopefully. We've prepared a very diverse program for you. We have five composers from five different countries. And we switched the program a little bit, the order. We're starting with Rachmaninoff. So Sergei Rachmaninoff was one of the most famous, important pianist and a composer himself. And this suite that we're playing is the only set that he wrote for four hands, meaning for two pianists and one piano. He wrote it when he was very young, and I have a feeling it's because later on he decided he didn't want to share the piano with anyone else. this piece really shows the youth of his music. It's very, very romantic, a little bit Chopin-esque, with some extra notes and flourishes. So we're playing three movements. Barcarolle is, as I've told all my students, it's a boat song, a very romantic boat song. Then we go on to Russian Theme, which is literally the title, it's a Russian song. And then we finish with a waltz. So here's Rachmaninoff.
Thank you. Time every major composer just about has composed for this medium from before Bach to the present day. Perhaps no composer has created more music for piano duet, two people at one piano, than Franz Schubert. Schubert certainly is regarded as one of the greatest composers. He died when he was, tragically, only 31 years old, but he produced one masterpiece after the other. And what is maybe truly miraculous is the last year of his life, he was very, very ill, he knew he was dying, he was extremely sick, it was hard for him to do anything, but he created extraordinary, some of the greatest works of Western art known to in existence, one after the other, as he was a dying man at the end of his life. And one of those pieces is the piece we're about to play, the Fantasy in F minor. Many two piano teams consider this the highlight of all the works for piano duet. It's a work of tremendous philosophical thought, tremendous emotion. It's a beautiful piece. It begins with a haunting, rather melancholy melody in F minor, and he takes this melody and through cyclic form, he brings it to so many different places. It's like what we often talk about it, taking a journey through life. Every human emotion seems to come through this piece until the very end with these crashing, extraordinary, rather dissonant chords that then bring us back to home base of F minor. It's a piece that we love performing and we hope you enjoy it also.
Thank you.
incredibly complex. You can analyze them. This has a fugue with a retrograde fugue, and you can analyze everything about it, and yet it just speaks for itself because it's just so well written. So we are ending this first half with three Slavonic dances by Antonín Dvořák, Czech composer from Bohemia. What was Bohemia back then? And these pieces were inspired actually by Brahms' Hungarian dances, which were Brahms' most profitable pieces he ever wrote, even though they were very short and kind of just fan favorites. So Dvořák also came to Brahms for advice on what he should write, and Brahms said pieces for four hands that are somehow inspired in folk music. So these three that we chose are Fast, Slow, Fast. And just to say that also we recently made an album with French music. We are not playing any of that music today. So if you want to hear the pieces, we have the CDs available and you can purchase them. But here's Dvořák, and see you in the second half. Thank you.
Thank you.
opera Carmen. A fun fact is that he's a French composer who had never been to Spain before he wrote Carmen. But these pieces are inspired on children's games, and they're just little gems of French music.
Thank you.
closing the program with a piece that hardly needs an introduction. Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue has been an audience favorite since its creation in the 1920s. It was premiered in New York in a special concert they called An Experiment in American Music. And the idea was to see what modern American composers were writing at the time. And it was a very important event that Stravinsky came, all sorts of luminaries in the musical world came. And Gershwin felt this was a very important piece for him because he was an extraordinarily successful composer of Broadway musicals and songs and things like that, incredibly successful. But he wanted to have so-called legitimacy in the classical music world and very much wanted to be alongside of maybe Beethoven and Mozart and everybody else. So this was important that this was at an important stage in New York. And it was actually written originally for piano and jazz band. And it's I've played it so many times in so many different guises, I'm sure Dr. Navarro has too, for piano with band, piano with orchestra. We're doing a two piano arrangement here.
Thank you.